A maritime industry expert urges the Philippines to continue pushing for reforms in its seafaring sector. Dr. and Captain Vivek Jain welcomes the Marcos administration's commitment to improve the industry after the European Union threatened to ban Filipino seafarers from its ships due to training deficiencies. Jain says there has to be a consistent improvement in the quality of education of seafarers.
If any country can ship up, it will be Philippines, because Filipino seafarers are the core of the maritime seafaring community. Shipping is changing very fast. The technology is changing fast. The requirement of green and sustainability skills is required. So okay. They need to shape up, including every stakeholder, including every maritime training institutes. Without that, is either you are in or you are out.
Now back here at home, the wreckage of the missing Cessna plane has been found in Apayao province. Our correspondent Jackie Manaba joins us on the line with the details of that. Jackie?
Ron, in a significant development, the Cessna 152 training aircraft that went missing yesterday, August 1, has been located by the search teams in Tuguegarao today, August 2. The Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines said that the aircraft was found at Barangay Salvacion Luna, Apayao. That's approximately 50 kilometers away from its intended destination, the Tuguegarao Airport. The search and retrieval operations are currently underway to recover the bodies of the two individuals who were on board the aircraft, the pilot and the student pilot. The identities of the victims have not been disclosed, pending notification of their families. The agency has also suspended operations of Echo Air, the operator of the concerned aircraft, until further notice. To ensure a thorough investigation, the Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines Aircraft Accident Investigation and Inquiry Board dispatched a team of investigators to the crash site. However, their arrival at the location will be contingent upon the completion of the body retrieval process. The AIIB investigators will also examine the wreckage, gather evidence, and interview witnesses to determine the cause of the crash. Their findings will be crucial in understanding the circumstances that led to this unfortunate event. The aircraft with registration number RPC8958 went missing August 1 after departing from Lawag International Airport at 12:16 p.m. It was scheduled to arrive at Tuguegarao Airport at 3:16 p.m. This Cessna 152 is a popular American two-seater fixed tricycle gear general aviation airplane primarily used for flight training or personal use. CAAP said that they will provide updates on the progress of the investigation as they become available. Ron?
That update from Jackie Manaba. Thank you very much, Jackie.
The Marcos administration is also seeking 10 billion pesos in surveillance funds next year. That's the same amount with the current fiscal year. Now, most of these funds are allocated under President Marcos's office as well as of Vice President Sara Duterte's. In the proposed spending plan, both Marcos and Duterte get separate confidential funds as agriculture and education chiefs, respectively. The Defense Department also gets more than 2 billion pesos. Budget Secretary Amena Pangandaman gives her assurance the funds have enough safeguards against misuse.
Alam niyo po, yung confidential and intel funds, meron naman pong guidelines yan from COA on how to use the funds. Hindi naman po siya budget na parang pagkabigay, they can actually disburse it and use it. Meron din pong dokumento na sinasubmit po sa COA. And then may breakdown din po yan when we request the budget. So it's not, there's full transparency po in terms of the request for these funds.
Over now to the deadly Rizal boat mishap. The Rizal Provincial Police says some survivors are now claiming there were no Coast Guard personnel on duty when the boat set sail. Initial investigations showed the boat that capsized was overloaded. The tragedy left 27 dead. Complaints have been filed against 5 people, including the boat's captain and owner.
Isa po sa salaysay din po na walang naka-duty nung araw. Nasa porto din po ng Binangonan Police Station ang boat captain while yung four po na respondent pa natin ay at large.
So walang nag-account. So kailangan talagang seryosohin na ng ating kumpanyas o mga personnel na nagpapatupad ng ating mga existing na mga batas. So matatala.
The